Hello students, welcome to another lecture of Pharmaceutical Jurisprudence. Today we will be studying about registration of pharmacist. So when you will also complete your graduation, then you will also register as pharmacist in your particular state pharmacy council, right? So today we'll be studying about the registration of pharmacist. So the Pharmacy Act, it provides for the registration of pharmacist to basically regulate the entry of people who are entering into the profession of pharmacy, right? It ensures that only those people who have proper qualification, experience and training enter the profession of pharmacy, as this particular profession deals with the life of an individual, right? Then the names of registered pharmacists, they are basically entered in the registers which are maintained by different state councils and central council. So the state council, as soon as it is constituted, it has the duty to maintain a register in accordance with the provisions which are laid down in the Pharmacy Act. There are certain particulars which are compulsory to be there in the register. So the first thing is that the full name and the residential address of the registered person should be mentioned. Secondly, the date of his first admission to the register should be mentioned. His qualification for the registration, meaning that whether he is a D-Pharm or whether he is a B-Pharm or whether he is an M-Pharm. Right? Then his professional address, meaning where he works. And if he is employed by any person, the name of such person. Meaning that if a person is working in a pharmacy, then the name of the pharmacy and the name of the owner of that particular pharmacy should be mentioned. And lastly, certain particulars which are necessary should be mentioned. Now, the state governments are responsible for maintaining and the preparation of the first register in each state after their constitution. Right, and the state government, when they are constituted, they basically form a registration tribunal consisting of three people. Registration tribunal is basically, you can say, a panel of experts. The registrar of the registration tribunal is the secretary also. And the state government, by notification, they can appoint a date on or before which the application for registration shall be made to the registration tribunal. Then the registration tribunal examine every application which is sent to it by different people before the last date. Then the first register, it is prepared after all the applications are examined by the registration tribunal and the names are published. And if any person feels that his name is not mentioned and it should have been mentioned, then he can appeal to the authority within 60 days from the date of the publication of the first register. And the registrar, who is also the secretary, he shall amend the register in accordance with the decision made by the authority appointed and issue to every person whose names are being mentioned in the first register a certificate of registration. Now, there are certain set of qualifications to be fulfilled if you want to get your name entered in the first register, right? So, the first qualification is that a person who has attained the age group of 18 years and if he resides or carries on the business or the profession of pharmacy in the state, and if he has the following qualifications. The first being he holds a degree or diploma in pharmacy or pharmaceutical chemistry or a chemist and a druggist diploma of any Indian university or a state government university. If he holds a degree of an Indian university other than a degree in pharmacy or pharmaceutical chemistry, and he has been engaged in the compounding of drugs in the hospital or any dispensary for a period of not less than 3 years. Or if the person has passed an examination which is recognized as adequate by the state government for compounders or dispensers. Compounders are basically people who can compound the drug products, who can distribute or give drug products to the general public. Or he has been engaged in the compounding of drugs in any hospital or any dispensary or any other place where drugs are regularly dispensed on prescription of a medical practitioner for a period of not less than 5 years. Now, there are certain special provisions for registration of certain group of people. For example, the register holds certain space for the names of displaced people who have been carrying on the business or profession of pharmacy as their principal means of livelihood from a date prior to the 4th day of March 1948 and who satisfies the conditions for the registration, which I already told you, right? Then secondly, the register also holds certain place for the individuals, for the citizens of India who have been carrying on the business or the profession of pharmacy in any country outside India and who satisfies with the conditions which are laid down for the registration as pharmacist, right? Now, the register also has certain space for the people who reside in an area which has subsequently become a territory of India and the people who satisfy the conditions which are laid down by the act for the registration of a pharmacist and the names of people who carry on the business or profession of pharmacy in a state and who were qualified for registration in the first register. The register also holds certain place for the people who have been engaged in the compounding of drugs in a hospital or dispensary or any other place for a period of not less than 5 years. So, coming to the renewal fee, a particular registration certificate is valid only for a particular time period, and if you want to continue your certificate, then you have to pay certain amount of fees, which is termed as basically the renewal fee. The state government by notification directs that for the retention of a name on the register after the 31st day of December of every year following the year in which the name is first entered on the register, that shall be paid annually to the state council, and such renewal fee may be prescribed, and where such directions have been made, such renewal fee shall be due to be paid before the first day of April of year to which it relates. Right? So it basically means that if your registration is valid up to 31st December 2020, right, then you need to pay the renewal fee till April 21 if you want to continue your registration, right? And when a renewal fee is not paid before the due date in the case of the registration of a pharmacist is first day of April, right? So if the fees is not paid till that particular date, then the registrar shall remove the name of the defaulter from the register. Then you again have to register as pharmacist, right? And the person whose name is removed from the register, he has to submit his registration certificate, surrender basically his registration certificate to the registrar. Now, coming to the removal of names from the register, sometimes what happens, there are certain conditions where a particular name has to be removed from the register. Firstly, if a name has been entered in the register by mistake, by error, then the name should be removed from the register, right? Then the name of the person should be removed from the register if that particular person has been convicted of any offense or has been found guilty of any infamous conduct in any professional respect, right, relating to the profession of pharmacy. Then person employed by him. Here the person employed by him means that if I own a pharmacy and I have a person under me working for me, right, so if that particular person conducts any offense, then the name of the person has to be removed from the register, right? So person employed by him for the purpose of his business of pharmacy has been convicted of any such offense or has been guilty of any such infamous conduct, right? So if a person working under me is found to be guilty of any offense or he conducts any infamous activity, then the name has to be removed from the register. So thank you so much, dear students. This was all in today's lecture. Today we started the registration of pharmacists. If you have any queries, any doubt, please feel free to reach out to me. In the next lecture, we will be starting with a new topic. So thank you so much for giving your time.